Hi guys, thank you for watching. For this video, I wanted to talk a little bit about why I started investing on my own. So in general, I started investing around 2010 when I was deployed. Instead of burning through that money, I wanted to make sure I can save it and at least, if anything, not lose it all. So when I came back from deployment, I took half of the money that I saved and I went to a financial advisor at my bank. At that point, I didn't know anything about investing. I wasn't interested in learning about investing, but I knew that if I didn't want to lose that money, I needed to do something with it that was better than just a savings account. I started a mutual fund with most of that money, and I also started an IRA for my wife since she was not employed at the time. What happened is the guy was supposed to call me every 6 months so that we can sit down and go through the portfolio that we had, that he had created for us, but that never happened. And I think 2 years went by and I had some questions, so I went back to the bank, and the person in charge of our portfolio was a completely different person. And so I asked the questions that I had, and then a couple of years later I went back and it was a different person again. And so by 2016, when I started listening to audiobooks and got interested in investing, retiring early and all that, that's when I started getting a little bit more of a basic knowledge of investing in the market, and you know what a bull market is, what a bear market is. And so then I realized that from 2010 to 2016, it was good years. The market was going up because of the crash that had just happened in 2008. And so once I found out what dividends were and gains and losses and all that, I decided to look at everything that we had invested. And I realized that my wife's IRA, even though I had been putting $150 a month for the last 6 years on top of the initial investment, I was sitting even, no gains, no losses. And I thought it was weird. So then I went into the details and I realized that the original guy had invested all the money into a cash fund. So basically it was worse than a savings account because there was zero interest. It was just a placeholder for cash. And so that meant that for the last 6 years, which, you know, on average the market goes up about 7%, or you can expect a 7% return on whatever investments. Sometimes it's higher, sometimes it's lower. But from 2010 to 2016, it was supposed to be, I think, around 14%. So we missed out on 14% each year with the compounding dividends and all that. And after I did the math, her account must have lost about $5,000 to $6,000, and there's nothing I can do about it. It was just, the guy was gone already. There was already 6 years and about 2 to 3 people that had came and gone. And so yeah, there's not like all I can do is just learn from that and start investing on my own. So that's what I did. And even though it's a little bit scary, especially when you first start or when you don't really have money to spare, I realized that that's the best option rather than just putting the money into a savings account. I think a savings account only gives you about 0.006% or some crazy number like that. I remember that I had a savings account and I wasn't really using it, but I had $1,500 in there for like a year. And at the end of that year, I got about 16 cents of interest or something crazy. And so I realized that I didn't want a savings account anymore. If the only money that I was going to keep in the checking account was going to be money that was needed for the bills or emergency. And so everything else went into the investment accounts that I talk about in my investing video. Right now, I'm still learning. There's a lot of stuff that I don't know or I don't understand. There's a lot of things that are kind of, I'm not as confident about, especially with researching companies. On my Robinhood strategy video, I talked mostly about technical investing, or basically looking at graphs to figure out if a company is doing good or doing bad. That's the easiest for me so far, but it's not really that in depth. And so it's really easy to pick something that you think is doing good and then it just collapses, especially if you don't really look deeper into what type of company it is, how long it's been around, and all that type of stuff. That other stuff is fundamental investing, which, as I mentioned on those videos, it's a lot more time consuming, and you really have to be confident, or I feel you really have to be confident about what all the measurements and all the numbers mean. An example is like the dividend yield for the year. You know, it might say something like, you know, 6%, And you think, oh wow, you know, I'm getting 6% dividend for each share, but then maybe it's the company itself is not doing that well, and it's just old enough that it was able to offer dividends. There's a lot of things that I still don't understand, but when you compare it to just having money under your mattress or having a savings account, it might feel safer, but at the end of the day, that loses you money because of inflation. And so, you know, if I have $10,000 under my mattress, those $10,000 at the end of the year is not going to be the same as before. It's gonna lose some value. And a savings account just can't keep up with inflation. So it only makes sense to me that investing in the stock market or index fund, that's a lot better than just having the money just sit there. So anyways, I want to do a YouTube live. I haven't done one yet, so I want to be able to kind of test that out and, you know, answer maybe some of your questions, not just on financial stuff, because obviously I'm not an expert on it, but also maybe just on some of the other things that I put on my channel, like keto or military life and those types of things.